choices. How do you choose what to put in and what to leave out?
Well, first of all, when we edit the voices, there's at least 3 takes. Sometimes it can go up to, say, 14 takes on a scene, but we try not to have that happen. And we go and compare each line, each phrase, and then make a decision on which one we think is the best and go with that one. It boils down to a person's sensibilities, basically. And then when we get it all edited, we listen to how all those pieces are flowing together, and then we'll make changes if necessary.
How do you make voices fade like they're walking away or coming closer?
We adjust the volume. Just bring the volume down on the voice, and that gives the idea that someone's further away, and then we bring the volume up, and they come closer. And then we add in some other effects to it, where we roll off the bass, the low end of the voice, and then bring it in as they come up. We can add reverb, bigger reverb as they're off further, and then less reverb as we come in.
One really cool thing that happens with it as well, if you get to listen to it in stereo, is you even do a bit of panning from left to right, and that
yes.
That gives the feeling of someone coming in from the side. What goes through your mind as you try to find the best sound effects for what's happening on the show? Well, what I would say here is just a matter of when you're going through the voice edit, kind of getting in your mind what exactly it is that you want to have sounding in certain places, whether it's a door, whether it's having kids in the background, like at Wits End. If you're outside, if you can hear a garbage truck going by and loading trash up, that's all going through your mind as you're working through the voice edit. And another interesting thing is whenever we go through our sound effects server, it's all in a computer, and we just go through sounds, and sometimes you come across some really cool stuff, and you just find places to put it because it's
that you weren't
something,
even thinking about.
Yeah, you weren't even thinking
so
about it.
So you have
it
to be open to the unexpected.
All right, our last question here is from Robert, age 14. He says, I'm working on a radio drama for my website. Do you have any tips on how I should go about sound editing and sound designing?
Well, I would say that good radio drama obviously starts with a good story. So concentrate on your story. Make it as exciting or as engaging as you can. And then when you get the acting, the best acting that you can put together with your friends or if you're doing the voices, and then I would say watch the pacing of the show. You don't want it going too fast, but you don't want it going too slow. That is very key to the start of a good production. And then I would also say to some of the technical things as far as mixing your show is to make sure your levels are good. You want it to be a nice listen for people as they listen to your show. So those are some of my tips. Do you have anything to add, Chris?
Yeah, Robert, I would just say just really listen to the world around you. Environments themselves are very interesting, and it's amazing when you stop and sit and listen to the things around you in real life, what actually is out there. And I think that's one of the key things to do when you're trying to design a show is just to listen.